When Ian Malcolm was rumoured and then confirmed to appear in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom next year, the internet pretty much squealed with delight. After all, Ian Malcolm led the second Jurassic Park film, and he was probably the breakout human character in the first. But if there is one man, one human who really embodies the Jurassic Park franchise, it's Alan Grant, as played by Sam Neill. Leading two films himself, Alan was the paleontologist we all wanted to grow up to be, this put-upon man who got to spend all his time out there in Montana in dig sites. He got to spend a lot of time with Ellie Sattler, and eventually he managed to live the dream of dinosaur fanatics everywhere, a trip to Jurassic Park. He also hated kids, in the film at least, and kids are the worst. Well, rumour is going around on the internet that Alan Grant is potentially in Fallen Kingdom for a cameo appearance, just like Jeff Goldblum. Let's just say up front, this is a rumour, pure and simple. Somebody working on the film, a few people have spotted him getting out of blacked out cars, that kind of thing. There really isn't any solidity behind this, but we're going to roll with it, we're going to speculate, and we're going to talk a little bit about what Alan Grant means to the franchise. It makes a lot of sense to me. There's been complaints that the trailer for Fallen Kingdom has revealed too much, but we've already had confirmation that it really only covers the first half of the film, so awesome reveals like Rexy taking down the Carnotaurus are just a little bit less important than they might be. The Indoraptor is likely to be the focus of the second half of the film, taking place primarily in Lockwood Manor, but again, we all know that's coming, even if it's not technically been confirmed by Universal yet. They need a hook, they need a twist, they need Alan Grant. Alan offered a different perspective on Jurassic Park than Malcolm did. Whilst the latter was primarily concerned with the running and the screaming and the folly of men who stand on the shoulders of giants, Grant was more focused on the beauty of the creatures around him and the desire to preserve them in a safe environment. I mean, you all saw him with the Triceratops. Alan Grant simply loved dinosaurs. His life revolved around them. In fact, in the novels, his character actually likes children, simply because he says it's impossible to dislike a group so enraptured and in love with these creatures, so boundlessly enthusiastic. Of course, that changes just a little bit after the first film. During Jurassic Park 3, Grant has a conversation with Eric, where Eric complains that Grant seemed to like dinosaurs a lot more in his first book rather than his second, because the latter took place after the events of Jurassic Park. Grant responds that, well, the dinosaurs hadn't quite tried to eat him by that point. Still, despite that, he shows reverence to the dinosaurs throughout the film, and is clearly still passionate about the subject since he's giving lectures on them at the start, and he's teaching Sattler's kid, the one who, you know, loves Barney a little bit too much, herbivorous dinosaurs probably didn't try to eat each other. He's a conflicted man who loves these creatures and wants them to survive, but is also very, very aware of just how dangerous they can be and has no respect for the people who created them. So what is his role in the franchise? I still think he's unique. Owen clearly has a lot of love for Blue, but other than the scene with the Apatosaurus, we never get a sense of his wonder in the face of these creatures. He doesn't seem to have the passion for dinosaurs, it's more like a job. Likewise, Claire, who initially at least approached the dinosaurs as tools to bring visitors to the park and nothing more. Again, she was clearly upset when the Apatosaurus dies, but who wouldn't be in the face of a dying creature? Alan Grant has to be the voice of reason who campaigns for the survival of these creatures. Isla Nublar is going to be ruined, and we're going to talk about that in an upcoming video, but Isla Sorna and potentially other islands in the island chain are still potential safe havens for these dinosaurs. Ian Malcolm likely doesn't care that much about their survival, but we know that Claire has started a dinosaur protection agency, one that leads the charge to go to the island and save the creatures from the volcano. Now, who would be a better guest speaker for such an organisation than Alan Grant? The man who still adores these creatures and wants them to survive, despite seeing people ripped apart before his eyes. Dinosaurs in these films are a lot like a lot of creatures in the real world, sharks in particular. Every year, a surfer gets killed by a shark, and there's calls from the public for tighter regulations, for hunting on these creatures, and stuff like that. Yet typically it's the surfers themselves who push back on this, surfers themselves who want to preserve the livelihood of sharks. Those who tangle with the natural world are well aware of the risks and that they are the ones who encroached upon the sharks' or dinosaurs' territory. Alan Grant is that kind of man. He wouldn't blame a T-Rex for eating him, but himself for not getting out of the way. If Alan Grant does return for what is sure to be a small cameo role, what would you like to see him do? given the trailer for Fallen Kingdom has a huge number of callbacks to the first film, including the Jeep that Alan Grant escaped from with Tim, or what definitely looks like it, this rumour seems like a pretty likely one to me, and I'd be really excited to see him back. Let me know what you think in the comments down below, and if there's any other aspect of the Jurassic Park films or games you'd like to see me cover, let me know in the comments as well. Before we go, a quick little story. Now, I obviously have a lot of respect for Sam Neill. Alan Grant was a big influence on me growing up and nearly led into a career in paleontology. So when I actually have Alan Grant's jacket from Jurassic Park 3. I'll do a proper video on that eventually. So when Alan Grant tweeted me about a year ago, it was incredibly exciting. Sam Neill tweeted me. These days he's more concerned with running a wine vineyard off in Australia, I believe. But he tweeted me. It was awesome. And you know what he tweeted me? He tweeted me because I spelled his name incorrectly. Yeah. Cheers. Much love. As always. Bye-bye. Hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, please consider smashing that like button down below, it really helps me out, and also hitting the subscribe button if you want to be kept up to date with brand new videos about dinosaurs, animals, aliens, and everything else we do here on the Best of Slot channel. All of you who have subscribed so far, that's awesome. Make sure you hit that little bell icon, I'll highlight now, otherwise you may actually miss out on the content anyway because YouTube is silly. Thank you guys so much, much love.